Hello, I'm Gina Szabo from Mitchell Elementary School. I'm the Dean of Students there, and I will be showing you how to use Synergy Mail. One thing I want you to keep in mind is that technology does happen, and so with that said, you might have some issues, and if you do, please feel free to reach out or watch some of our other videos that we have presented to you. All right, so what you're looking at right now is our Synergy login, and you get there by going to aps.edu. If you're having trouble logging in or you can't find your ParentVue account, please look at another one of the videos in the series. So you're going to log into ParentVue, and you're going to enter your username and your password. So if you're having trouble logging in again, because technology does happen, go ahead and look at the first video in this series on how to log in. So what you're going to do is you're going to click on Synergy Mail in the top of the left side, just like that. And you can find six categories. The categories there are the inbox, your alerts, the send, and it looks like a little airplane, a paper airplane, your drafts, the trash, and your outbox. Now those are the different categories in Synergy. So from the middle into the right side of the page, you can find three columns. Okay, you have your from, so you can find out who the message is from. You also have the subject, so it'll tell you what the subject of the email is. And then you have the date. It'll tell you the date and the time that that email was sent to you. Now, if you go back to the inbox, you can see how many emails you have by looking at the blue number. Those are your read and unread messages. And the subject will be in the top, right? And then the date. And then if you go down to the date, you can see who sent the email right there from. It could be a teacher, it could be a counselor, it could be even just an APS mail to all parents. It's really important to check your Synergy email because there are messages not only from your teachers, but also from the district as well. You'll get important messages about registration, pre-registration, how to register. You'll also get important emails about attendance, or you'll get important emails from the teacher on just checking in with students. If you want to reply, that means that you're going to answer directly to one of these senders. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at one of these emails. And I want you to keep in mind that the emails that you receive in Synergy are also emails for any other children that you have within the district. So if you have a high schooler, a middle schooler, or an elementary school student, you'll receive all emails for those students within this inbox. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at one of these emails. So we're going to click on the email. And as it opens up, you can see that it has the subject up at the top. It has the date that the message was sent, and it will also tell you who it's from. And then in the body of the email, so that would be after the greeting, it shows you the message that you have. If you would like to reply directly to this email, you're going to click on reply, which is up at the top. And you can choose to reply to this person. You can even add other people that you would like to see this email by going to your directory. You can choose another staff member, or maybe there is another person you would like to receive it, another family member or a counselor. So you could put those emails in there as long as their contact information is within Synergy. Once you've decided who you're going to send it to, you can click and drag and then click on OK. You'll see that you have who the message is going to, what it's in regards to, and then you have the body of the message underneath. You'll notice that the other email that you're replying to is beneath, so you can start typing in here. Now, as you can see, you can type in what you need to type in, and then when you are ready, there are all kinds of other options here. Now, I could get into the whole nitty gritty of you can change fonts to bold, you can change to different sizes, you can put it in the middle or do the left indent, right indent. There are so many different options at the top. It is very similar to writing a document on Word if you've ever written a document on Word. So you can kind of get, you know, as creative as you'd like. Now, if you want to add an attachment, meaning you would like to add a picture or maybe an assignment, you can click on Add Attachment. When you click on that, what will happen is it'll open up a different window for you to look at. And you would add something from your computer or however you want to do it, maybe a picture or something. Once it's added in there, it'll show that it has an attachment by showing a little paperclip. And you'll see that at the bottom right there. It shows you that you have one attachment that you're sending with this. Now, when you're ready to send your message, everything looks good and you think that it is perfect, then you can go ahead and click send. And that is the green button on the upper left-hand corner. So once you send that message, it will show in your inbox, but it's actually going to show it as a sent message. So when we go back, to that little paper airplane, it'll show messages that you sent here. So if you ever want to verify or make sure that you sent a message and when that message was sent, just click on the little airplane that says sent, and it'll show you how many you've sent and what messages there are. Now, if you haven't sent a message yet and you think you did, but you're like, oh no, it's not in the sent, then I'm going to go to drafts. So when you go to the drafts window, you're going to look in there and it'll show you all the messages you have as drafts. You can open it up. And then you can send it. You can put who it's to, you can change it up as much as you need to. Now, if you want to save a message, this is where you would save them in your drafts in order to get them later on when you're ready to send those messages. Now, if you don't want to keep any of the messages, then you are going to use the trash can. And you can use that little delete at the top and you can trash that message. Or you can use the trash can as well and see what messages are in there and then go back. Now, there's a lot of shortcuts and things that you can do. So when you want to add a file to the trash, what you can do is you can go up to the top next to Compose, to the right of Compose. And this is your folder button. So you can click for a new folder, or if you click and you can name whatever folder you want. So if you want to name this folder for one of your students in, or one of your children in elementary school, you can put Daisy's mail or Daisy's assignments or, you know, anything of that nature. And you can save all of these emails into separate folders for each child. And then you would just click save. Once that's done, you'll see where your folders are by clicking on the little down arrow of the icon. All right, so if you look at your inbox, you have these numbers on the bottom, and it will display 1 to 15, and there you go, 15 or 20. So the numbers increase, and you can choose how many messages you decide to see on your inbox as you go in. If you scan your little mouse over to the right, then you will see page numbers. And if you click on those different pages, that means that's how many pages of emails you have. Depending on the setting that you have for the numbers, that's how many pages you'll get. So you can skip all the way to the end by going to that double arrow to the right, or you can just browse by page. And you just click on the number of the page. Once you know how many emails you have in there, the other thing to be aware of is not just your inbox, but you want to be aware of the alerts that you're receiving. These alerts are set by teachers, counselors, or anybody in school that is using Synergy to respond to you or to communicate with you. So by clicking on there, you can see the really important messages. Maybe it's a check-in by a teacher. Maybe it's a missed assignment. But teachers and any staff member that has access to Synergy can put these alerts within Synergy for it to be viewable on ParentVue email. Now, in order to receive these emails, you want to make sure that your settings are set properly to the correct email address. So you're going to go up to the More button, and I want you to scroll down to where it says Settings. And as you scroll on Settings, it's going to tell you the email addresses that you have on file. Now, you want to make sure that these are the correct email addresses for all the communication that you're receiving within Synergy. Once you are sure of that, you can click on the box that says forward a copy of Synergy mail messages to the following email addresses. So it's really important to make sure that all of your information in Synergy is updated so you receive every single part of communication through Synergy mail. Once you know that those are the proper ones, you can click on Save, and it takes you back to your inbox. All right, so looking here in the settings, you want to make sure that your information is correct and that your email addresses are correct in order to receive any type of communication through Synergy. Now you'll click that little box that says forward to, and if those are the proper email addresses, then you're going to click on Save. Now, if your email addresses are incorrect when you check on those settings, what you'll want to do is you'll want to go up to My Account, and you'll click on My Account, and you could change your email within there, or you may contact the school in order to do that. The how to change it in My Account is also another video within this series, and so you can look at that one as well if you need some help, or contact the school. And that brings us back to our inbox. And again, using Synergy email is important to receive messages, to communicate with your teachers, to communicate with school staff, but most of all, so you are in the loop of everything that's going on. All right, so in this day and age, everything is on the tech sphere. And so we want to make sure that we know what emails we're receiving. I receive upwards of 100 emails per day. And so if I really want to find one, what I need to do is I need to use our little search button, which has become my best friend. And that is a little magnifying glass. You're going to click on that one, and you can type in whatever email you're searching for. So maybe I was searching for something from Daisy, or maybe I was searching for something from a teacher or registration, and I don't remember where that email was. So I'm going to type it in, and you'll see that it fills up. The bottom fills up with all kinds of different emails that have that keyword in them, and you can choose whatever email it was that you were looking for. And whoo, there's the one. All right, so then I could click on that, get the information from it. You can also check by the date. So, hey, I know I received an email sometime last week or the beginning of February. Here we go. And the calendar is a great feature in that search as well. You can use keywords, you can use the date, and you can also, I don't know if you have the capability to use it by the name of the person that sent it to you. So maybe you think that it was from one of the teachers. So you could type in a teacher's name and see where those emails are. And I love search. Search is amazing, and it always saves me a tremendous amount of time. I hope you learned something new. I hope you learned something that you will be able to use. And remember that you can always contact your school if you need any help. Thank you for joining, and enjoy our series.